This video is sponsored by Squarespace, the best way to make an amazing website. Now I know you guys are gonna call me crazy over this 5K iMac Reviews title, especially since there is so much hype over the new redesigned Apple Silicon Macs that we're expecting this year, but the reality is that there are people out there that need to buy a machine right now instead of waiting. So what I'm gonna do in this video is prove to you guys that out of all of the Intel Macs available right now from Apple, the 5K iMac is by far the best choice because of two reasons. It has the best combination of features and very high-end performance for a great price, and I personally believe that it's gonna hold its value way better than any other Intel Mac. So for people who can't wait months and months for the high-end Apple Silicon Macs to finally get released, like for those who need a powerful Mac right now for work, business, or other productivity work, I'm gonna explain how to save the most amount of money during this Apple Silicon transition while still getting a great machine that you can use right now. But before I get into how Apple's GPU upgrades for the 5K iMac are grossly underpriced, as well as some interesting performance benchmarks, let me give a huge shout out to the sponsor of this video, Squarespace. If you've been thinking about making your own website, now is the perfect time, and Squarespace is seriously the best way to go. You can build a great looking website like we did with literally no web making experience. It doesn't matter if you want a portfolio, a blog, e-commerce, or anything else, you just choose a template and customize blocks of text and images and move them around. It's incredibly simple, affordable, and ours have been running flawlessly for over 2 years, bringing in new clients thanks to its built-in SEO tools. Start your free 2-week trial with no credit card required by going to squarespace.com/maxtech or use our custom link below when you're ready to launch to save 10% on your first purchase of a website or domain. Now, yes, we do currently recommend the M1 Max because they're simply great, but they definitely aren't perfect for those who need a lot of performance or specific features. While the M1 chip is very fast, the 5K iMac 8 core is a lot faster and longer workloads, as you can see in Cinebench R23. And in terms of graphics, the 5K iMac can get almost 3 times more graphics performance with the 5700 XT GPU. And of course, the iMac has better port selection, and it comes with an extremely good 5K display for a great price. And unlike the M1 Mac Mini, the iMac gets a keyboard and mouse bundled in, and the iMac also has the option for a 10 gigabit Ethernet port, which the M1 does not have. On top of that, the iMac also has the ability to get a massive amount of user replaceable RAM, saving you a ton of money compared to the M1 Mini, where the RAM is soldered and limited to 16 gig. And of course, user replaceable RAM will be going away in future Apple Silicon Macs, as we've already seen with the M1 Mac Mini. And on top of that, the M1 Macs still have limited official display support as well. But the absolute biggest limiting factor with the M1 chip is the relatively low graphics performance. So for people who need as much GPU power as possible, like high-end video editors, or people who want to do some gaming via bootcamp, which by the way is gone on M1 Macs, they have to go for something else, so let me prove to you why the 5K Intel iMac is the best choice. Previously, it made sense to get an Intel Mac Mini and buy an eGPU if you wanted to do some gaming using bootcamp, since you could get an eGPU setup for around $700 total. Or you could, of course, just build a gaming PC. But as of right now, there is a massive graphics card shortage. All of the new GPUs are literally sold out, and any of the old ones still in stock are massively overpriced. We used to use the 5700 XT in all of our eGPU testing videos because it offered the best bang for the buck, being priced under $400. Yes, I said under $400. Look, let me prove it to you. This Amazon screenshot from one of our eGPU videos is from just 8 months ago. Yes, that's $380 for a 5700 XT. And right now, there is literally only one listing for $1,400 brand new. Or if you look at used Amazon listings, you can get it for a cool $1,200. Not bad. Just kidding, it's terrible. But for more realistic pricing, I checked eBay to see the prices that they're actually selling for right now, and it looks like around $950 to $1,000 is the current fair price. That is insane, considering that you used to be able to buy a 5700 XT for $380 just 8 months ago. So yeah, gamers are really struggling right now. And when I say gamers, I mean Windows PC gamers, because for the first time in a long time, Apple is ironically undercharging for their graphics chip upgrades on the 5K iMac. Check this out. Let's go to the 27-inch iMac on Apple's website and choose the high-end $2,300 model, which we recommend because of its great value. Then head down to the graphics upgrade options and bam, only $300 to upgrade to a 5700 GPU, and then just $200 on top of that for a 5700 XT. And this isn't just any old 5700 XT either. It's the only one on the entire market that comes with 16 gigabytes of VRAM. So it's an even better card than any of the desktop versions, which are limited to 8 gigs and are selling right now for almost $1,000. So people who want a game right now can simply buy a 5K iMac with this underpriced 5700 XT GPU and then use Bootcamp to install Windows 10 and enjoy 4K gaming at 70 to 80 FPS in COD Warzone, or 144 FPS gaming at 1440p playing Fortnite. And of course, you also get a powerful machine with a killer 5K display and macOS for doing productivity work in apps like Xcode, Final Cut, Logic, and much more. So you basically get the best of both worlds by saving so much money on those pricey GPUs. And the most important thing to consider is that analysts aren't expecting this chip shortage to end anytime soon. So GPU prices could remain this high for many more months. So the point that I'm trying to make is that this 5K iMac is actually looking like an incredibly good deal right now, especially for gamers, since it's probably the last good Mac to get true Bootcamp support. Now, with all of that said, there is still one more thing to consider. We know that most of the Intel Macs are gonna get replaced sometime this year with Apple Silicon chips, including this 27-inch 5K iMac. So why in the world would anybody buy one right now? Well, there are a couple of different reasons. Of course, there are people who need something literally right now with more power than the Apple M1 Max can offer. And this 5K iMac is still the best bang for the buck high performance Mac that you can get right now. Besides that, I honestly believe that out of all of the Intel Macs out there, this one is gonna hold its value the best, and let me explain why. First off, it's the last Intel iMac to get an update, and it was actually a massive update in terms of the performance. Another reason is because the current Intel Mac Mini and all of the MacBooks, even the 16-inch MacBook Pros, are already getting crushed by the M1 Max. And we also know that those MacBook Pros are getting replaced by totally redesigned models with even better chips by this fall or sooner. The Intel Mac Pro got hit the worst, basically being a massive fail of a product, as Max talked about in his recent video. And the iMac Pro was just completely discontinued, so that's no longer an option. And as for the current 21.5-inch Intel iMac, it's weak in the first place, and it's about to get replaced next month at Apple's April event with a new Apple Silicon model. So that basically leaves the 5K iMac as the last one standing with very high performance, a ton of versatility with Bootcamp support, and of course, relatively cheap GPU upgrade options. And yes, this 5K iMac will also be replaced by an Apple Silicon version, but we've been digging through a lot of leaks and rumors, and it seems like all signs are pointing to this 5K iMac being the last Mac besides the Mac Pro to get replaced near the end of this year, probably in November or December, which is gonna help it hold its value much longer. So here's the way that I would play the situation if I was someone who needs to buy a machine right now, but also wants to save as much money as possible during this Apple Silicon transition. Of course, buy the 5K iMac model you want right now and enjoy it for the next few months. And then when the 16-inch MacBook Pro with the M1X comes out, which will probably be sometime this fall, order that and then sell this iMac when you get the 16-inch in your hands. That way, you're selling it while it still has a lot of its value, because once the new high-end Apple Silicon iMac comes out later this year, the value of this iMac will finally start to drop. Now, of course, you're still gonna be losing money because that's what happens when you buy something brand new, but out of all of the Intel Macs out there, this 5K iMac will lose the least during the transition. So for those who need a Mac more powerful than the M1 Max right now, it's definitely the best choice. Now, if by some chance you could hold off and wait until the 24-inch iMac gets released, that will also be a good choice if you want an iMac. But keep in mind that it won't support boot camp, it probably won't have as much graphics power as the 5700 XT, and of course, the display will be quite a bit smaller as well. So if you need all of those things right now, then this 5K iMac is the one to buy. If you totally disagree with my opinion and speculations, then leave a comment down below. But if you enjoyed it, go ahead and click the circle button to subscribe. Definitely check out one of those two videos right there. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you in the next video.